Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of LSP4. Today we're using a 2013 Ford Explorer and we're using the Gardena Police Department skin in today's episode. Now this vehicle is in a vehicle pack that you can get off of LSP4's website. I was able to download it through the LSP4's website and it's going to be in the vehicle models once you get on LSP4's website. So just go to the vehicle models, scroll through there, you should find it, and it should say something in the title about Gardena Police. And whenever you find it, just click on it and then download it, and then there you go. The skin comes with the vehicles that you see in the pictures when you go to download the vehicle pack. So yeah, and you can have a slick top and a Valet bar and a Crown Vic, and I believe that's all the vehicles you can have. But there was a 2016 Explorer, but I wanted to use a 2013 because I don't really like the 2016 Explorer. So the Gardena Police also uses the red and blue light bar setup, so that's what we're going to be using in today's episode. So anyways, we're going to be out here in the Mira Park area, the Vinewood area. So dispatch, show me 10-8 and let's get on patrol. I have a call of a possible intoxicated person in Hallwick, or how do that's pronounced. We're going to respond to that. It's going to be, person jaywalking across the road. Come on, dude. But anyways, we're going to be responding to intoxicated person in Hallwick or something like that, however it's pronounced. That's how the dispatcher was saying it, so I guess that's the way you're supposed to pronounce it. We're going to be responding to this code 2, because you never know how intoxicated person can act, so we'll be responding to it code 2. Looks like it's going to be on the interstate, actually. Come on, move out of the way, people. Dispatch, show me 1097. Looks like it's going to be on North US Route 1. It's going to be on the other side of the road, so we'll have to...
Dispatch, we have a visual.
Looks like the individual is running, so we need to go code 3 to this now. Because he's running on the interstate. Dispatch, it's going to be on South US Route 1. We're going to shut our siren off. It looked like the guy was running towards traffic. He's intoxicated, so I'm not sure what his intentions are. Dispatch, I'm going to be out with a black male with a red jersey that says number 7 on the back with a short... his blue shirt, short sleeve shirt, and jeans on. We're going to approach with caution. I'm going to go ahead and get my taser out just in case he tries to do anything. Gardena Police, can you speak with me for a second? Oh, nope, nope. Drop the knife. Get on the ground. Dispatch, taser been deployed on the black male. Get rid of the knife. Drop it. Get on the ground for me. Dispatch, I'm going to have one black male, 1015. I'm going to run Josh in the database.
1015, suspect in custody. We are code 4. No further units required.
Alright, Josh Sandman comes back. Valid no warrants. Alright, so right now, I'm going to place him in arrest for public intoxication and aggravated assault. Because he tried to stab me with the knife, so I'll go ahead. But he didn't get to stab me, so yeah, we're just gonna charge him with aggravated assault and public intoxication. All right, sir, I'm gonna go ahead and place you in arrest for aggravated assault and public intoxication. I'm gonna go ahead and pat you down. So as I'm gonna be patching you down, am I gonna find anything that's gonna poke me, stick me, hurt me in any way when I go to search you? We'll go ahead and do a DUI or a breathalyzer test on him real quick. Go ahead and hop in the back, watch your head. At least this vehicle works for putting people in the back of the vehicle. Alright, sir, just go ahead and blow into this clear tube until I say stop, and stop. Alright, sir, you blew over the alcohol limit, so you'd be... Place an arrest for the aggravated assault from where you're trying to stab me with a knife and for the being drunk in public. So public intoxication. Alright, and I'm going to read you your rights. You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and be used to get you in the court of law. You have the right to have an attorney. If you can't afford one, it won't be appointed to you by the court. Do you understand these rights as I read them to you? Dispatch, scene's going to be code 4. I need a 1016 for a black male that I have 1015. We're just going to pull off the side of the road and put our traffic advisor on. Alright, there's the transport unit. They're going to be taking them into the detention center. I know I have my traffic advisor going the wrong way, but it doesn't really matter. Anyways, we'll be 10-8 from here. Everything's going to be code 4, so dispatch, show me 10-8. Just had a jaywalker right here. Just look at this. They tried to get, they almost got hit multiple times, so I'm going to go ahead and just speak with them real quick. I'm going to throw on all of my lights. Look at that, now he's walking right back. This is the guy that's got almost hit multiple times. I'm going to go ahead and speak with him. Dispatch, I'm going to be out with a white male jaywalking across the road of Elgin Avenue and Vinewood Boulevard. Hello, sir. Gardena Police, can you stop for just
you
a second?
You moron.
What is happening?
I can go climb a tree.
Can you just stop jaywalking, sir? Just don't be jaywalking anymore, alright? Because, I mean, you almost got hit multiple times.
Oh, excellent vehicle you've got there.
I wish I could interact with him, but it won't let me do it, so...
Oh,
whatever. Alright, I mentioned to him not to jaywalk anymore, so... Hopefully he will just learn. I was going to give him a citation, but I can't interact with him, so... Whatever. Anyways, we'll be 10-8 from here, and... Yeah, we'll get back out there and see what's going on.
We got a person
carrying a knife. Person with the knife. Looks like he's going to be behind us. So we're responding code 3 at this time to be en route of a person with a knife. Not sure what this person with the knife is supposedly doing, but all we know is that there's a person with a knife and we have a location. So dispatch, show me 1097. We're going shut. Oh, we got stabbing. Dispatch, it's going to be a white male, white shirt. Stay where you are. Drop the knife. Get on the ground. Dispatch, you need medical.
Attention all units. We have
get on the ground. Do not move. Get on the ground. Dispatch station has been deployed.
LSPD.
Last chance. Get on the ground. Drop the knife. Continue to resist. You'll be tased again. Get on the ground. Medical is en route. They've just right down the road. We got a medical en route to see if they can get the victim back up. Right now they're bleeding out, so hopefully they're able to get him back up. Or get her back up, I should say.
Get over there, stat. Don't die on me.
John Pete. We're going to go ahead and run him in the database. Right now he's going to be on arrest for aggravated assault, attempted murder, or if she is dead, we'll go ahead and charge him with first degree murder.
We might be too late.
But right now, I'm not sure if he... Yeah, she's not dead. Alright, so we'll go ahead and do attempted murder and aggravated assault. Alright, sir. I'm going to go ahead and search you. So why is that noise keep... Why is it keep making that noise? Anyways. Alright, sir. I'm going to go ahead and search you. So as I'm going to be searching you, am I going to find anything that's going to poke me, stick me, hurt me in any way when I go search you? Right now you're going to be charged with aggravated assault and attempted murder. And possession of the 3 ounces of cocaine that you have on you. Go ahead and step in the back of the vehicle and watch your head. You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and it'll be used against you in the court of law. You have the right to have an attorney. If you can't afford one, one will be appointed to you in the court of law. Do you understand these rights as I've read them to you? We'll go ahead and just do a drug test. Oh, thanks, medical. I appreciate you taking off my door. But anyways, we'll go ahead and do a drug test to make sure he's not intoxicated. We'll go ahead and do an alcohol test on him real quick, or a breathalyzer test, I should say. Go ahead and blow into his clear tube. All right, so it looks like the individual failed to provide a alcohol or a breathalyzer test. So we'll go ahead and get a prison transport to our location for him. Dispatch, you need a 1016 for a white male that have 1015. Scene's going to be code 4. Female's going to be 10-4. Alright, ma'am. He's going to be placed in arrest right now for the attempted murder and aggravated assault. Hopefully you'll be alright in the next couple of days from the stabbing. But if you have no questions for me, then you'll be free to go. Alright, so she survived, which is good. I mean, she did get stabbed. That was not what we wanted, but, you know, it happened, so whatever. We'll have to fix our car because medical took out our door, so dispatch, show me 10-8 and scene's going to be code 4. Alright, we're going to be stopping this black fuchsia here in just a minute as soon as we get to his intersection. They have a, looks like some smoke coming from the hood there, and they also have like a pop tire. I'm not sure which side it is, but I heard them riding on the rim earlier, so we'll pull them over once we get through this intersection. Currently it is red, so we'll go ahead and just sit tight for just a second until we can get through this intersection. I don't have all my lights going, so that's why the vehicle won't pull over until then, so go ahead and activate all our lights. Dispatch, we'll have 1081. It's going to be on a black fuchsia light. It's going to be West Glory Way and Popular Street. Stand by for license plate. Hopefully they'll pull over there where that yellow stuff is. License plate is going to be 20, Uniform November, Charlie 534. So I'm going to go ahead and take a look and see which, yeah, it looks like it's going to be the front one on the driver's side.
Union, Nora,
hello, sir.
Five,
I'm with
three,
the...
Four, no, 1099.
All right, license plate comes back valid and all that. All right, hello, sir. I'm with the Gardena Police Department. You know why I pulled you over today? Pulled you over because your vehicle has some smoke coming from the hood there, and then your tire is gone. From the front driver's side here, you're just running on the rim. What happened to your vehicle? Needs a trip to the garage, officer. Would you have a license, registration, insurance?
Get
Plum. Alright, Eric Johnson, just sit tight for just a second. So we're not going to be able to let him leave from here with the vehicle since the conditions are not that good. I mean, I'm not sure why it's smoking anyways, but then also he's running on a rim. Eric Johnson comes back valid, no warrants. He's got one citation, stopped two times. License, or not license, but registration insurance is valid. It comes back to an Eric Johnson. The vehicle is a fuchsia-laden, plate matches. Alright, everything checks out. He has no warrants. License is valid. And insurance and registration is valid. So we'll go ahead and just ask him to step out and either call him a taxi or he can walk home and tow the vehicle to his residence or the customs or the garage that he's supposed to be getting it repaired at. Alright, sir, go ahead and step out of the vehicle for me. I'm going to be calling you a taxi, so just hold on for a second. Dispatch, I will need a taxi for a white male on Poplar Street and Interstate 1. Sir, your vehicle will be towed to your residence or the garage shop, depending on or the shop that you're trying to get the vehicle repaired at. So it's up to you on where it wants to go, but I'll be towing it to wherever you want to put it. Take it to. Dispatch, I need a 1048 for the vehicle. So we're going to be getting a tow truck down here to tow the vehicle. Not sure where he wants it towed to, but either it'll be the residence or the garage that he's supposed to be getting it fixed at. Alright, there's the tow truck. So they're going to be towing the vehicle. He's going to be in the taxi going home. So dispatch, show me 10-8 and let's get back out there and see what else is going on. Right, we have a call of a possible burglary. It's going to be a silent alarm call. It looks like it's going to be a residence. It looks like it's going to be in Muir Park. So they want us to respond quietly, but also quickly. So we'll be responding code 2 to this. But we'll try to make it a fast response time. So dispatch, show me in route. I'm going to be code 2 at this time. It's going to be on Mirror Drive. It's going to be a Mirror Park, so it looks like it's going to be some residents that are off Mirror Drive. Dispatch, over 1097.
Attention Attention all units.
Investigate the area for suspicious activity. We have a vehicle over here yep, this is it. He just dropped something on the ground. Hey, nope. Hey, get out of the vehicle. Dispatch. There's going to be two individuals getting into a vehicle, leaving, and it looks like it's going to be a black stratum. They're going to be coming out. It's going to be in the... Oh, man, they just 10:45 to a light pole. Alright, I pinned them in so they won't be able to move. Step out of the vehicle. Put your hands up. Get out of the vehicle.
Police! Stop whatever the
Both
hell
of you,
you're
put
doing.
Your hands up. Get on the ground, sir. Get on the ground.
Stop! Police!
Dispatch, we're going to have both individuals on the ground. Now get on the ground. Stay where you are. Do not move. I'm going to get additionals down here.
Attention all units. We have a
I'm going to go ahead and arrest the driver real quick. So the driver was the getaway in this. Burglary call. Suspect's gonna be detained at the moment. And we're gonna go ahead and arrest the passenger as well, because he's the one that involved in this as well. Go ahead and run. I don't know whose name this is gonna be that we're running, but we'll go ahead and run somebody's name. So one of these guys have a warrant for the arrest. I'm not sure which one, but one of them does. So we're gonna go ahead and mute our siren because it is awful loud. So,
sorry,
oh man, what the heck is going on? Okay, so we'll go ahead and just park our car out here. And not sure what's going on. Okay, thought it was gonna crash for a second, but we'll go ahead and park our vehicle out here and go ahead and search him all that stuff and see what's going on here. So we'll go ahead and pick up the driver, and I'm going to go ahead and search him. So, alright, sir, I'm going to go ahead and pat you down. So, as I'm going to be patting you down, is there anything going to poke me, stick me, hurt me in any way?
Get foul.
Dispatch, will have two Hispanic males detained at this time. Alright, sir, in the yellow shirt, can you go ahead and stand up for me? I'm going to pat you down, so as I'm going to be patting you down, am I going to find anything that's going to poke me, stick me, hurt me in any way? So the, they were fleeing. Okay, he has 2 pounds of marijuana. Alright, so he's going to jail. For sure, passenger's going to jail. Now, one of these guys have a warrant for the rest. I'm not sure which one, but we'll go ahead and do a license plate check. Why not? Dispatch, I'm going to need a license plate check on a black stratum. It's going to be 80 Juliet Golf Zulu 944. Alright, these guys are just going to stand right here or sit there. I'm going to go ahead and see what's over here that he dropped on the floor. Vehicle's going to be stolen, so the driver and the passenger will be going to jail today. You recover some evidence of a computer disc. Okay. Alright, so looks like it's going to be both of them are going to jail today. I'm going to go and do a search on the vehicle real quick. Passenger's going to jail for theft of a computer disk, I believe. That's what they said. He's also going to jail for possession of marijuana. The driver is going to be... One of them has a warrant. I'm not sure which one because... It don't say which one. It just shows like names, and there's I don't really know which one because there's two of them. So not sure who has a warrant, but who has a warrant will be also going in for that. But the passenger will be going to jail for theft of the computer disk and possession of marijuana because he has 2 pounds of marijuana. The driver here will be going to jail for theft of a vehicle or possession of a vehicle. Or a possession of a stolen vehicle, I should say. And he's also going to be going to jail for... I forgot what else there is. Oh, fleeing. So, felony evading. Because he wouldn't stop. He was just trying to get away from me, so... We got a tow truck en route to pick up the vehicle. Dispatch, you need 1048 to Muir Drive for a vehicle. I'm going to call two single transport units for both of them too.
Assistance required for a
there's no homeowner. It looks like it's going to be on scene, so there's nothing I can really do as far as like talk to him or anything. The passenger will also be going to jail for burglary because they went inside and stole the computer disk that was inside, so he also will be going to jail for that. The driver's not going to be going to jail for, I guess he would be going to jail for burglary too because he kind of helped in this case. Alright, so the scene's going to be code 4, everything's getting cleaned up, the prison transports are picking up the individuals, and they just ran over one of them. Tow trucks picked up the vehicle, so dispatch show me 10-8 from here, but we're going to end today's episode right here. So if you guys did enjoy today's video, if you did enjoy, make sure to leave a like on the video, subscribe down below, and I'll see you guys next time. Thanks for watching.